my mom for a pet tiger. And she said that I was absolutely insane. So I was like, it's just a larger cat. But yeah, now I realize, yeah, I was insane. But that did not stop me from learning everything I possibly could about tigers. And today I would like to inform you about a lot of my random knowledge on tigers. So I want to tell you about like relationships between tigers, their behavioral aspects, and their population decline, as well as giving you a little bit of background information on their appearance. So, a tiger's appearance. So tigers stand about 3.5 feet at the shoulder, so that's about, I don't know, up to my chest. And their length is an average of 4.8 to 9.5 feet. So they are probably about 3 feet longer than the tallest person here. Their height varies depending on subspecies. So you'll have the Siberian tiger, which is the largest subspecies, is 400 to 675 pounds, while the Sumatran tiger, which is the smallest subspecies, is 220 to 310 pounds. Their lifespan is about 10 to 15 years, but there have been tigers known to live 26 years in the wild. This is a white tiger. Now, a lot of people think that the white tiger is actually a separate subspecies, but that is false. It's a recessive gene carried in tigers. So any tiger subspecies can be a white tiger. So you can have a white tiger that is a sibling to an orange tiger. No two tigers have the same markings on their coats. They are as individual as human fingerprints. So that's how tigers can tell each other apart, is by their stripe pattern. And this fact is from LiveScience.com. Tigers' behavior. So tigers tend to be solitary creatures. They like to live alone. They do not live or get along very well together. You will find like territories overlapping, but that's generally more common with female tigers than males. Females tend to get along a little bit more. Male tigers, you will only see one in an area at a time unless they're fighting over females. Tigers tend to communicate with body language. They don't really make much noise unless they're in inherent danger or trying to ward off other tigers. So they communicate with moving their ears, with their tail position, and other things. Researchers believe that due to the human populations and pressures increasing in recent centuries, tigers have adapted to become more nocturnal so that they don't run into humans. And this is from the book Tigers by Rebecca Sneffel. Population. Now this picture is a little old, just it's the best one I could find. It's from 2006, but it's still pretty recent because it hasn't changed much. Originally there were 8 subspecies, and now there's only 5. 3 of them have become extinct. South Chinese tigers are about the closest to the original tigers. Because tigers have adapted over the years. Beginning of 20th century with 40,000 tigers in India alone, and now in the 21st century, there's only 5,000 to 7,000 total in the world. So 96% of wild tigers have disappeared in the last 100 years. This is a world map of where tigers live. The black area is the area where tigers have gone extinct. Those are extinct subspecies. Yellow areas where they used to live, and then the different colored areas, different subspecies. So estimated total of the tigers left in the world could fit in BGSU football stadium and live comfortably. And that is actually quoted from Animal Planet. Reproduction. So death rate for newborn cubs is fairly high. You'll only have about 2 to 3 that survive within like the first months. And they die from starvation because you always have the dominant tiger that steals food from the other siblings. Predators fire because their legs aren't fast enough to escape fire if there's fire in the habitat. And swimming because the mom tigers will teach the baby tigers how to swim, and sometimes there'll be alligators or crocodiles that will come up and snatch them. Mating season is mostly from around November to April. Pregnancy for a mom tiger lasts about only 103 days. Litter size, 3 to 4 cubs. Cubs follow the mom out of the den at around 8 weeks and tend to leave the mom at 2.5 years. And that's from Defenders of Wildlife website. A mother with cubs will hunt about 17 to 22 pounds per day. Times that by 12 months, it equals 6,600 pounds, which is about 40 animals a year. And this is from actually a live documentary from Animal Planet. And here's my sources. And this is all important because it allows you to know more about tigers, since there are few tigers left in the world that live in the wild. A lot of their living habits have changed. But just some important information to know. Thank you.